Like other companies, we're in this era of real experimentation. I think over the next 3 to 5 years, you're going to have real competition with conventional cable, you know, coming at you from Apple TV, coming at you from Netflix, coming at you from Google, and all these other directions. And we want to be part of that conversation, and we want to be experimenting both with quick hit interviews, which is kind of our specialty because we have such great access to members of Congress and people in the campaigns, but then also original programming. And I think over the next year, you're going to see us do a lot more of that, invest more money, invest more resources in trying to come up with shows, they might be 2 minutes, they might be 10 minutes, that help people better understand politics, both the serious side, the fun side, the funny side of what's happening. We have this one show, Turn the Tables, that John Harris does, where on Fridays he interviews all of the Sunday hosts to find out who are you going to have on and what is the news you're trying to make. And it's great because all of the hosts play ball. So you get to hear from David Gregory and Christiane Amanpour and others and George Stephanopoulos, whoever's doing the show on any given day, what they're thinking about and what they're going to try to do on this Sunday show. Again, for our audience, they love this stuff. They love the personalities, they love the politics, and they love the tactics.
Cool. And what do you see the value of tape pieces versus going live?
I think it all depends. Like going live only works, I think, in certain settings when you can command a big enough audience to make it worth the investment. So Super Tuesday is a great one. But I think any big election night for us where we can get, you know, tens of thousands of people to tune in, whether it's on TV or through the website, to listen to us talk about politics. Like we all are here because we have a screw loose. Like we love politics. We really follow this stuff in a pretty compulsive way. And there's tons of people who want to hear from us and hear from people who are on the road. What is it like to be with Romney? Is he good to the press? Is he bad to the press? Do you fight with the campaign? You know, what do you see from him behind the scenes that we don't get to hear about on other programs? And I think that's a dimension that we're uniquely positioned to deliver. And we don't mind yanking back the curtain, letting people inside the newsroom to hear about how we're reporting stories. Like throughout the night, we'll probably go and talk to Harris, for instance, and get John's thinking on, well, what are you going to do for an analysis tonight? How do you think we'll interpret this race? How do you think reporters broadly will interpret it? On Michigan, for instance, we spent a lot of time just talking about this dark art of interpretation that political reporters do and what would actually constitute a victory for Mitt Romney. Was it 3 points, 4 points, 5 points? And it was fascinating because that the answer to that question dictates how so many people will report on the story and then consume the story.